Back to school is right around the corner, and this month, we're helping you get prepared for some things that you may experience soon. Today, we're looking at one of the most fun events of the school year, the science fair. I'll be testing your science fair knowledge as we look at some of the craziest and best science fair projects and the rules that make the competition as fun as it is. Let's go play the game and start getting schooled on the science fair. All right. Number one, in the world of science, a hypothesis is an educated guess, a type of chemical reaction, or the conclusion of an experiment. I do remember this because it was on multiple tests when I was growing up, and it is an educated guess. It is letter A, confidently saying, it is, nice job. Let's check out number two. In what year was the science fair created? 1477, 1894, or 1942? Wow. I'm gonna go right there in the middle with letter B, 1894. 1942, wow, okay, that is pretty cool. All right, number three, the original name for the science fair was, bam, new science, or uh-oh kids, making explosions, or C, the science talent search. You know, gonna go with C on this one, the science talent search. C, the science talent search. Nice. Number four, the EUCYS, the Europe Union Science Fair, gives away how much money to the winner of the science fair? $12,000, $10,000, or $5,000? If I won, I want all of that money. But I think for the winner of that one, I'm gonna go $10,000. It is, what, $12,000? That's a good prize. Which of these presentation tools would you often find at a school science fair? Is it the laser projector, trifold cardboard, or holograms? Well, A and C would be really cool, but I think realistically it is B. Yes, the trifold cardboard board. Have you seen those? They unfold, you can put your entire project on them. They're so cool. Which of these science projects would you most likely be able to find at a school fair? The teleportation device, amazing. The baking soda volcano, probably. Or the perpetual motion machine. Don't even know what that is. Gonna go with B, the baking soda volcano. Nice, I've definitely made a few of those in my years. All right, our final question. The scientific method has how many steps? Is it five, is it seven, or is it nine steps? Come on, come back to me. It has seven steps. Ah, yes! That was a wild guess, but we definitely got it. The scientific method has seven steps. Step one, question. Two, research. Three, hypothesis. Four, experiment. Five, observations. Six, results, conclusion. And finally, step seven, communicate. Great job during the game, everyone. Now it's time for us to get schooled on something else, the Bible. Let's hit it, it's Bible time.